Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to write the expressions of the sine and the cosine functions in trigonometry. Find the x and the y components of a force. Solve an exercise about the force components.
Let's study the sine and the cosine functions in trigonometry. Consider the right-angled triangle ABC. Now look at the angle alpha. Side AB in the triangle is the adjacent side for the angle alpha, while side BC is the opposite side for this angle. Let's start with cosine alpha. Cosine alpha equals the adjacent side, which is AB, over the hypotenuse side, which is AC. The hypotenuse side is the longest side in the triangle. Therefore, AB equals AC cosine alpha. Let's move to sine alpha. Sine alpha equals the opposite side, which is BC, over the hypotenuse side, which is AC. Then BC equals AC sine alpha. Let's move to angle beta. Cosine beta equals BC, which is the adjacent side for the angle beta, over AC, the hypotenuse side. Then BC equals AC cosine beta. Again, sine beta equals the opposite side to angle beta, which is AB, over the hypotenuse AC. Then AB equals AC sine beta.
Let's study the components of a vector. A vector F lies in XY plane as shown in the figure in this PHET animation. The vector FX is the component of F along the x-axis, or it is the projection of F onto the x-axis, while the vector FY is the component of F along the y-axis, or it is the projection of F onto the y-axis. The vector FY can be drawn so that its tail coincides with the origin O, or its tail coincides with the tip of the vector FX. Then the vector F can be written as the vector FX plus the vector FY. Since the vector FX is oriented along the x-axis, then this vector can be written as FX times I, where FX is the algebraic value of the vector FX and I is a unit vector oriented along the positive x-axis. And the vector FY can be written as FY times J, where FY is the algebraic value of the vector FY and J is a unit vector oriented along the positive y-axis. Now, let's determine the expressions of Fx and Fy. Look at the figure. In the right-angled triangle formed by F, Fx and Fy, cosine alpha is equal to the adjacent over the hypotenuse. So cosine alpha equals Fx over F. Then Fx equals F cosine alpha. Sine alpha is given by the opposite over the hypotenuse. So sine alpha equals Fy over X over F. Then Fy equals F sine alpha. Now replace Fx by F cosine alpha and Fy by F sine alpha. Therefore, the vector F can be written as F cosine alpha I plus F sine alpha j. Remark, tangent alpha is equal to the opposite over the adjacent. So tangent alpha equals Fy over Fx, where alpha is the angle between the vector F and the positive x-axis.
Let's find the components of some forces. Let's start with force F1. Force F1 is drawn in the figure. F1x is the x component of the force and F1y is the y component. These are the components of F1. F1x makes an angle alpha with the negative x-axis. f1x equals minus f1 cosine alpha. The x component vector of this force is negative because it is directed in the negative x direction. And we use cosine alpha because f1x is adjacent to the angle alpha as shown in the figure. F1y equals f1 sine alpha. The y component vector is positive because it is directed in the positive y direction, and we use sine alpha because f1y is opposite to the angle alpha. Then f1 equals minus f1 cosine alpha I plus f1 sine alpha j.
Now, let's find the component of the force F2. As you see, F2 is parallel to the y-axis, so F2 has no components along the x-axis. Then, F2x or the x-component of F2 equals 0. F2 is oriented along the positive y-axis, so the y-component of F2 equals F2. Therefore, F2 vector equals F2 times j. Now, consider a force F3. As we see, F3 has no components along the y-axis, so the y-component of F3 equals 0. F3 is oriented along the negative x-axis, then the x-component, or F3x, equals minus F3. Therefore, F3 vector equals minus F3 times I.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, let's solve an application about the x and the y components of a force. Fadi is pushing a box up an incline by applying a force F which is directed parallel to the incline upwards. During its motion up the incline, the box of mass 10 kilograms is under the action of its weight W, a friction force F of magnitude 40 newtons, a normal force N of magnitude 80 newtons, and the force F of magnitude 120 newtons. Determine for each force the values of its component vectors along the x-axis and the y-axis.
Let's start with the force F applied by Fadi. Look at the figure. Since F is oriented along the positive x-axis, that means it has no component along the y-axis. Then F can be written as Fxi, where Fx is a positive, equals 120 newtons. Then Fx equals 120 newtons, or the x-component of F equals 120 newtons, and the y-component of F equals 0. Now, let's study the friction force. Look at the figure. The friction force is oriented along the negative x-axis. That means it has no component along the y-axis. Then F can be written as Fxi, or the x-component of the friction is equal to minus 40 newtons. Then the x-component of the friction equals minus 40, and the y-component of this force equals 0. Now consider the normal force N. N is oriented along the positive y-axis, so it has no component along the x-axis. Then N can be written as nyj. That means the y-component of N equals 80 newtons and the x-component of N equals 0.
Let's find the x and the y components of the weight of the box. First, let's calculate its magnitude. W equals m times g, the mass is 10 kilograms, and the gravitational acceleration is 10 meters per second squared. Then the magnitude of the weight of the box is 100 newtons. Now let's draw the x and the y components of the weight. This is the x component and this is the y component. Let's start with the x component. Wx equals minus w sine alpha. The x component vector is negative because it is directed in the negative x direction. And we use sine alpha because the x component vector is opposite to the angle alpha. Now let's calculate its value. The magnitude of the weight is 100 newtons and sine alpha is 0.6. Then Wx equals minus 60 newtons. Let's move to the y component. wy equals minus w cosine alpha. The y component vector of the weight is negative because it is directed in the negative y direction. And we use cosine alpha because the y component is adjacent to the angle alpha. Now let's calculate its value. W equals 100 newtons, cosine alpha equals 0.8. Therefore, Wy equals minus 80 newtons.
In order not to confuse, let's study these two figures. In the first figure, the x-axis is oriented positively downward, and in the second figure, the x-axis is oriented positively upward. Let's study the x-component of the weight, or Wx. In the first figure, Wx is oriented positively along the x-axis, then Wx is positive, so it is equal to W sine alpha, or equals mg sine alpha. In the second figure, Wx is oriented along the negative x-axis, so Wx now is negative, then Wx can be written as minus W sine alpha, which is equal to minus mg sine alpha.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.